reluctantly crouched at the starting line. Engines pumping and thumping in time. The green light flashes, the flags go up. Churning and burning, they yearn for the cup. They deftly maneuver and muscle for rank. Fuel burning fast on an empty tank. Reckless and wild, they pour through the turns. Their prowess is potent and secretly stern. As they speed through the finish, the flags go down. The fans get up and they get out of town. The arena is empty, except for one man still driving and striving as fast as he can. The sun has gone down and the moon has come up. And long ago somebody left with the cup. But he's driving and striving and hugging the turns and thinking of someone for whom he still burns. He's going the distance. He's going for speed. She's all alone in a time of need. Because he's racing and pacing and plotting the course. He's fighting and biting and riding on his horse. He's going the distance.
Today it's the first day of the World Championship. We are at Lake Egonza. And we tried to sail the World Championship and the North American Championship this week.
Oh, it's the beginning of regattas, especially in ice boats, I get the heebie-jeebies.
Every key component of our equipment has to be marked because we are limited to use a certain number of sails, like two sails, nine runners, one hull, one plank, one mast. And each of the components that we use has to wear a sticker. So at the check-in, we get a set of stickers for every part and we have to put them on before the first race.
We're going to the skipper's meeting.
Welcome to 2023 Worlds. My name is Pat Pepper. If you haven't met me, my name is Pat Pepper. I'm the PRL for the event.
Please give any ice fisherman a wide berth. We want to keep the peace out here.
This affectionately is known as the pits, and this is where everybody right now is trying to make their decision on what to take along.
Checking my new sail.
There's no wind, so we wait.
We'll do a wind dance of some sort, you know. They used to do that. They used to have a guy out here with the drum and bells and everything, and he'd put on this Norwegian hat and he'd come out, do a wind dance, yeah.
What we do now is waiting for wind. We have a great chance to go through all the equipment and make selection of stuff, gears that we want to bring with us on the ice, and that means extra sail, extra runners.
You got your own little rocket ship that you can tweak out and make faster, you know, and you just spend a little extra time and work on your runners to get the right profile, get the right bend in the mast, right bend in the plank, get the cockpit so it fits you so you can move forward and aft as the different pressures, a tiller that slides, and all little things you can tweak out and make them work, especially for your weight and your system of sailing.
I'm really lucky. I got my dad's boat. It's been a struggle learning to tune it to meet my size. When I get the cover off, you'll see where I'm trying to shrink the size of the inside of the boat so I don't like roll around like a ping pong ball. The guys just don't understand that they're locked in and I'm just like rattling around.
We make all our own, and a lot of guys here like to make their own, and it's such a neat feeling to go out there and race in something that you've created. You know, it's neat. Love making my own things and racing in them. Yeah, it's fun.
28 centimeters between the top of the block and the bottom of the block here, such that I don't oversheat.
This guy's the first Australian who's ever sailed an Iceboat World Championship, to my knowledge.
The first DN Regatta. Yesterday was my second time sailing one. Right now it's just being a sponge and trying to take in all the information from everybody. Later on I'll try and distinguish what was the good information and what was the bad information, but...
I can't tell you how many good friends I have from all over the world, and this is one of the most important things. Talk about international relations. This is really it. The best thing you can do is go out and beat your buddies.
Go up and check out my trailer. My trailer holds 10 boats, and I've got five Europeans that came in to sail with us, and I store their equipment in Detroit, and then they store my equipment in Germany. They have my my racing gear, my helmets, my goggles, my track shoes, my race suits, everything in a bag over there. And so all I have to do is jump on the plane with a carry-on bag and I can go sailing, which is what I like.
It's going to be a lot of pressure to score the first two qualifier races. They're big fleets. It's light air today. There will probably be more boats than not that don't complete the three laps, so it makes it challenging for the scorers and puts a lot of pressure on us. I've got a really good team of scorers. We're a team and they're very competent.
Well, it's opening day and I think it's Copper Fleeters. We are the Sacrificial Lambs. We do the first race.
I think the first thing is to see the bronze fleet qualifier and the top sailors from bronze seat qualifier. They will already give an indication what kind of runners are sailing fast. And we also, even though we have some imagination about what we want to use, we will have a better picture when we see the top guys finishing and checking what they are using.
There, everybody's going to be looking at what those top four or five boats have on, as far as what sail they have on, how they have it rigged, where the position of the mast might be.
Yeah, I don't know. You got anything out there?
The ice is quite rough, and I think the choose of a medium sail and a full sail will be quite good. But you have to ask the experts about it.
It's getting ready, you know. Don't want to be too late today. It will be very fantastic racing, I think. Fantastic racing, challenging racing, because the wind will be shifty. Anyway, the ice is bumpy and covered with snow, so that's not going to be only speed competition, but as well tactical racing. You have to read the wind, which you can't see it. On the lake, there will be a lot of wind shifts, a lot of different in the wind strength. So you have to make sure you stay in the paths, you search for the paths, and the speed helps a lot, you know, to be famous. And I hope to be going fast, despite I didn't bring all my equipment from Poland. I didn't come here to win. I did come here to have a fun and sail as best as I can. It's going to be a long competition, I think 3 days of racing. Let's see how it goes.
Yes. The sailors sail out, they're going to have their boats loaded with all kinds of equipment.
We need to load like a camels, bring this gears to the waiting zone, and then change the runners, sail a little bit and check what works best.
This is going to be the windward mark.
It's a gorgeous day, right? I mean, how could you not have fun today seeing all our friends? So my big decision, I'm wondering, snow slippers or my 316 100s are longer in the back and snow slipper in the front. So I'm, of course, not an expert. That's why I'm peeking. And I see way such a variety. I don't know who to copy. I think if I screw up, it's going to be because of my sailing, not because of my runners. I also didn't start even sailing until I was, 47. I'm not gonna catch up to that, but that's okay because I'm very happy in my little group going around the course safely and having a great time. I'm not gonna win the world, and that doesn't matter.
I'm a newbie completely. When these guys speak, I do what they say, trying to learn.
Thinking about is that the wind is actually picking up, so we're pretty heavy about that. And also not running over the line with our runners and ruining it. It's an actual line, I know. Literal line. And if you break it, you buy it.
Six women in this fleet of 105.
So we got three fleets, bronze, silver, and gold. There are going to be 12 spots in bronze. The top 12 will qualify for the silver fleet race, and the top 12 from the silver fleet will qualify for gold fleet. So we're in the qualifying stage at the moment. Everybody's lining up.
You start where you finish the last race. So all the odd place finishes go one way and all the even numbers go the other way. But pretty much just set your boat up on the tag and wait until they say go.
The flag is up! Go!
We'll be right back.
the first bronze fleet plus qualifier. Lucky enough to find the breeze all the way around the racetrack three times. Well, now the top 12 boats move up into predetermined slots in the silver fleet, and then we do it all again.
And the top five have to come into the zone and get checked out. We inspect the boats for compliance to the measurement rule.
Out of the far cockpit.
I went in and I said, and it was like not enough. And then boom, wind machine was off. He extended there, and you know, he was gone.
I went left, and then I tried to check, and I completely stopped, and I got out of my door, and I went back.
Actually the first time in the period I'm sailing, I'm winning the first gold fleet race in a world championship. I did it on the Europeans, I never did it at the Worlds. We're going in, it was a great day, and we're going to work out the situation tomorrow and keep on going, try to do as good I can.
My friend Chad Atkins has a saying that I think applies to this class. When you shake the freak tree, we come out.
I told him everything he knows.
Welcome to the second day of the World Championship on Lake Kegonza.
Yeah, the world is seasonal spirit. Made the original out of clay and then made a mold of it, and we built five boats and an opti. We call it our little Wawasee wind spirit, so yeah.
See, 5 to 10 knots, maybe building as the day goes on, might have 15 at the end. Could be exciting at the lure mark, that's for sure.
I've got five layers on plus my down jacket. Weighting, as you can see, a lot of weighting.
Dread, wicked eyes lit on the lead. The tears don't stop the fire. It's killing time. Back from the dead. See their eyes got nothing left. Kiss me, I am the cobra. It's killing time.
That was the Mother Nature providing for us. So, great day on the ice. So, congratulations. The snow is blowing into drifts. What I've observed on the race course is drifts are about exactly 1 inch tall. Make sure you're out there early. Do a little sailing around and make sure you pick your runners accordingly.
All right, gold fleet to the line! Gold fleet to the line!
Thank you.
World Cup is Matt Struble.
My wife was my greatest supporter, and we trained together week in and week out, and driving around all of Minnesota looking for ice. But I was 100% focused on this regatta and this championship. Thank you so much.